Hey everyone! Hello once again from Pastor Britt Strohecker on the positive side of Facebook, and this is Closer to God. We're in the book of Romans studying it, so before we get back to our study, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, you are an amazing God. How great you truly are. We want to get closer to you, and in order to do that, we need to study your holy word to understand more about you so that not only can we get that understanding of you, but we can converse with you by you talking to us through your word and us responding to your word by discussing it. So Lord, we thank you for this opportunity and we pray your Holy Spirit to guide and direct us as we continue our study. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, so we're in Romans chapter 1 and we're in a section called God's Anger at Sin. And yesterday we went through 18 to verse 20, only a few verses there, but there was a lot that was said in that paragraph. So we're going to move on to the next paragraph, which is verse 21. So Romans chapter 1, verse 21, just a reminder, I'm using the New Living Translation. Here it says, yes, they knew God. And last section, the last episode, if you want to jump back to it, remember, Paul said there's no excuse whatsoever for not knowing God. So at verse 21, Paul says, you know what? Yes, they knew God, but they wouldn't worship him as God or even give him thanks. And they began to think up foolish ideas of what God was like. The result was that their minds became dark and confused. So before we talk about result, let's talk about what he says here. Yes, people know that there is a God or can see evidence for a great possibility that God truly does exist, okay? But some people choose not to worship him as God or even give him any thanks for the things that he has done, not only in the world around us and the creation around us, but the things he has done for us as individuals, or maybe as families, or maybe as communities, or maybe as church congregations, or maybe as countries, you know, whatever the case may be, you know, they did not worship God or even give him thanks. And then they decided that we're going to define who God is instead of allowing him to tell us who he is. And that's why it's important that we do what we do here on Closer to God. If we want to draw closer to him, we need to allow him to reveal himself to us through his holy word. We cannot sit here. I mean, If we did not look at his Bible, you know, just set this aside, okay? If we set it aside, we can say, okay, what do you guys think God is like? We could sit around in a circle of folks, and if we didn't refer to the scriptures, can you imagine the things that we would say about God? Some may be true, some may be partially true, but a lot of it would be just who we want God to be instead of allowing God to tell us who he truly is. And that's what Paul says, you know, when they, even if they knew God and didn't worship him or even give him thanks, they would normally try to define him and create God in their image instead of allowing God to form them in his image. Okay. And then he says, what's the result of that? Well, the result of that is our minds become dark and confused. Dark meaning we go to a dark place instead of turning towards the light. And remember, Jesus said, I am the light of the world. That's God saying, I am the light of the world. I am the light that's going to light the path before you and show you the truth in all things and show you the way I want you to go. So instead of choosing that, why would you choose to darkness? You know, I'm going to try to do this my own way. I'm going to try to do my own thing. I'm going to try to be somebody that I want to be instead of discovering who God created me to be, you know, and that can lead to a lot of confusion because when people are trying to find themselves and they have no direction or guidance for that, they usually end up one week or 1 month or for a season of time, they're this type of person. And then they change and say, nah, I'm not going to be that person anymore. I'm going to be this person. And they try to go along with the fads. They try to go along with the world. They try to fit in with the in crowd, you know, and they find out that the in crowd changes or sometimes the in crowd will reject them. Or if you don't conform to what the in crowd wants, they'll cast you out. So that's why Paul's saying, you know, if you try to do all that, all you're going to do is walk into darkness and be confused. Why not go into the light and have everything cleared up and have a clear understanding of what the truth really is? And too many people in this world are perfectly fine for settling for living a lie or living according to lies that the world is giving them. So Paul's saying, I don't understand this, and this is what our choices are. This is why we should worship God, okay? This is why we should give him thanks. This is why we need to know who God is and get to know God and bring him closer to us in our lives instead of pushing him away or rejecting him when we feel his presence is uncomfortable for us to deal with. So at verse 22, it says, claiming to be wise, they became utter fools instead. And that's what's Paul saying here. A lot of people think that they are smarter than the average guy. And I'll tell you what, you can see this very plainly and very clearly. And those people, oh, I don't believe that there is a God. I think that's mythical nonsense. I believe in science. I believe in logic. I believe in philosophy. I believe in reality. Well, that's another way of saying I'm becoming an utter fool because I'm trying to look like somebody who is smart, but instead I'm proving that I'm somebody who's very foolish. So Paul's pointing that out. You see how Paul's not really sugarcoating anything here. He's saying, you know, claiming to be wise, they became utter fools instead. And instead of worshiping the glorious, ever-living God, they worshiped idols made to look like mere people or birds or animals and snakes. This is a huge statement here because people do exchange other things for God, you know? Sometimes they worship a lifestyle instead of God. Sometimes they worship a career instead of God. Sometimes they worship a habit that's most often harmful to them instead of God. Sometimes they worship another person instead of God. You know, they idolize somebody. Maybe it's a celebrity. Maybe it's someone they have a crush on or they're in love with. Maybe it's somebody who they want to be like. You know, if you want to be like anybody, be like Jesus. All right? You don't need to be like somebody else in order to try to find acceptance and worth in this world. If you want acceptance and worth, you go to Jesus and you will find those things and he will show you who you are. And then you will be able to live a good, happy, healthy, and productive life. Okay? And these are the things that Paul's pointing out here. You know, don't be a fool. Don't be an idiot by worshiping idols that are made to look like mere people or birds and animals and snakes. And you know what? Sometimes you're going to find that there are certainly people out there that are snakes in the grass. They will woo you and they will try to persuade you and manipulate you. But in the end, all they're trying to do is use you. That's a snake in the grass. Don't fall for that. And don't worship those accolades and that praise and that smooth talk that they use with you. Because if you read between the lines or look behind what's behind their words, you might find somebody who's a very evil and wicked person who's only trying to manipulate you and use you for their purposes and their advantage. And that's what Paul's saying. You need to look out for these things, people. Don't allow these things to come into your life and make you miserable or take you on a path of darkness or take you away from God's plan and purpose and meaning and love that he has for you and your life. So until next time, remember, nothing in this world is more important than the love of Jesus Christ.